Hello, my name is Katya Mijatovic, and I'm the Principal Data Scientist at Data Society.
meldR is our learn and experience communications platform that is driven by meldR Engine. meldR Engine consists of multiple components and services linked together through several pipelines that serve different aspects of meldR. Each pipeline runs within a Docker image, where we spin up isolated Conda environments that include both standard and custom-built proprietary Python packages. The key to ensuring all pieces fit together is dependency handling and potential dependency conflict resolution, which Conda enables us to do smoothly. meldR app has a content page that contains course materials and a link to an isolated environment that students can use to practice. Here's an example of such a course, simple linear regression in Python. When a student clicks on this button, connect to workspace, a JupyterLab instance is spun up on our Jupyter Hub server. Within each workspace, students will be able to see a set of materials that they will need for the course. The set includes a code notebook, like this one, an exercise notebook where students can practice. They can also access sample answers for their exercises if they so desire. And students also have access to the actual content, the slides that come along with the instruction. Each set of such materials is generated by our scraper pipeline. Scraper pipeline is dependent on several packages, including a custom course scraper. It's a package that takes in a folder with custom markdown files that include content and code for each course, like simple linear regression. For all these things to work smoothly and be reproducible in our local environment and running on our remote engine, we choose Conda to handle heavy dependency lifting and environment spinning. Our course scraper pipeline requires a set of dependencies, both standard Python and R packages, along with custom proprietary packages like the course scraper, to be installed within a given Anaconda environment. The list of dependencies is stored in a YAML file that we use to create our custom Conda environment. Here's an example of such file. It has the environment name, the channels we would like to use, the actual dependencies in Python, in R, and the dependencies that we would like to install through pip. At the bottom of this list, you can see there are four packages used by a given environment: generate KC, cleaning functions, GCP operations, data file operations. All four packages are the custom packages that we build and stored in our artifact registry. Scraper pipeline artifact registry packages are located in here, and they include the course scraper itself and the generate KCs. We also have other dependencies that are linked to other pipelines and projects that we use. Whenever we would like to make a change to our environment, we update our Conda YAML file with the updated version of the package, and the Bitbucket pipeline pushes the updated image to our artifact registry and stores it in our Docker image repository. Once the image is built, it can then be used by our cloud build pipeline. Cloud build pipeline pulls the image, then creates the Conda environment, and then uses the actual script to scrape the materials. Final materials, when generated, are placed in a GCS bucket from where we actually serve those materials to the Jupyter Hub environment that we created for our students. Another way to use our Conda environment with custom packages is to install them on the fly within the environment. This allows us to test packages locally before we push them up to our artifact registry for the pipeline application to use.